Okay, so I feel the need to revisit my channel review series to talk about not one channel, but a specific group of channels, aka reaction channels. Also, no, I'm not talking about the bigger reaction channels that usually react to YouTube videos. No, Grade A Underrated has already crucified those ones. I'm talking about the ones who specifically react to actual episodes of cartoons. These channels usually only talk about the same cartoons, commonly Voltron, Steven Universe, Star vs. the Forces of Evil, OKKO, and Adventure Time. I don't know why that's the case, I don't know if they all just seem to have the same taste in cartoons, or perhaps the content ID of those shows is absolute crap. I mean, I can guarantee that if these channels decided to react to a Viacom or Fox-owned show, they would be screwed, but whatever, that's just my speculation. Now, there might be other cartoon reaction channels that are more successful, but the ones I found were Harlan Dante, who for some reason wears these heart-shaped thingies and demon horns whenever he watches Star vs. the Forces of Evil, which makes him look stupid. Then there's I Am Zember, who's admittedly one of the better ones, since she does at least edit some parts out, and she's in general more reactive in words. I mean, I still have an issue with the length of her videos, and I wish she would add more commentary, but she's at least somewhat better than the other even crappier reaction channels. Then there's Lunar Eclipse 09, who's also more reactive than other reactionists, but still not enough to justify the length. I've also noticed that she alters the audio pitch of the episodes. I don't know why, but honestly, that's completely irrelevant. Then there's Mr. Freakins, who's probably my least favorite because of how boring he is. Plus, he has done some ethically questionable things, which I'll address later in the video. Now, of course, these channels don't just upload reaction videos. Sometimes they upload reviews and announcements, subscriber specials, trailer reactions, and stuff. Now, I don't want to talk about that other stuff. I just want to talk about the reaction videos. Now, my main issue with these videos is pretty obvious. They do not fall under fair use. What makes an I Hate Everything trying to watch video okay, and these videos not okay? The difference is that I Hate Everything doesn't upload his entire reaction, which would lead him to upload the entire movie. His videos are usually less than half the length of the movies he's reacting, and when he's doing so, he's offering entertaining commentary that in and of itself could even be material that's worthy enough for a review. These reaction channels, however, upload the entire episode, and most of the reaction consists of them making natural responses, like laughter or quick remark that's just not enough to justify uploading the entire episode. When the commentary material that you're offering is 10 times smaller and more insignificant than the copyrighted material that's included, it's definitely not fair use. Another thing that's very important when it comes to fair use is that the video must not serve as a substitute for the original copyrighted content. An argument I hear from people defending reaction videos is that the addition of a person reacting to the video slash episode adds to the reaction video enough to make it transformative, which I strongly disagree. There are videos on YouTube where people upload episodes of television shows and place the footage in a specific location while there's a random background picture covering the rest of the video. Can you honestly tell me that by doing that, they're not infringing copyright laws and they are actually doing something transformative? Of course not, and quite honestly, that's exactly how I see reaction channels. Sure, they might not be as bad as those other videos since they at least offer something that adds to the experience, even if it's redundant, but in my opinion, both these types of videos are damaging for the same reason. They are stealing someone else's hard work by uploading the entire episode to their terrible YouTube channels without their permission, and as a result, they are providing an illegal service that they can distribute free content of which they have no permission to do so. And what makes it even more messed up is that they are also screwing with border licensing. If you don't know what I'm talking about, let me explain. Outside of North America, accessing American television shows is a bit more complicated. Unlike people living in the US, I'm incapable of watching their shows through their basic platforms, like their official cable channels, website, and online services. Hell, I can't even access some of their YouTube channels. If I'm living overseas, the only way I can watch an American show is by either hope that a streaming service like Netflix or a cable network like AXN has the license to stream or air that show, or hope that there's an official international version of that channel that broadcasts that show, which even then, they might not necessarily air the show immediately after they're originally released in the US. Now, this might sound like a pain in the butt, but hey, if that's how these networks want to handle their shows, they have every right to do so. Which is why it infuriates me when I see these channels showing off entire episodes and making them public to the entire world, including countries that are technically aren't even allowed to watch those shows. Or worse, sometimes they might even upload their reactions before they air in the US. And I have proof. Around April, Adventure Time decided to air their third miniseries Elements by airing 2 episodes per day for an entire week. Unfortunately, before the episode started airing on Cartoon Network, all of the episodes got leaked online. I don't know if it's because CN released those episodes on iTunes early or something like that, but regardless, some of the reaction channels took advantage of that by reacting to those episodes before they started airing on their official channel. See it for yourself. Oh, speaking of Mr. Freakins, in one if not more of his Adventure Time reviews, he linked a Kiss cartoon page in his description, thus inevitably leading to the promotion of that site to his fans. Now look, I'm not going to pretend I've never used Kiss cartoon and Kiss anime, but promoting it on your YouTube channel? That's a new low. Also, there's a chance that these channels also make money off those videos. I mean, I've seen ads, and unless I'm giving proof that these videos were third-party claim, I'm assuming that they're being monetized by the YouTubers themselves. Now, listen, I don't think these YouTubers are bad people. At least, I don't have enough reason to believe they're bad people. I honestly just think they're making a huge mistake. If any one of the people whom I mentioned in this video happen to watch this, I'd love to receive a response from you. I'm open to a discussion. Anyway, that's all I have to say. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Bye for now.